Mountain residents anxious to get back to their homes have lined up for the chance to do so. We've had a chance to meet with some of these folks, or at least Eric Spillman has, and we have vicariously. We wanted to check in with him one more time and the folks standing in line in San Bernardino where sheriff's deputies are handing out those gold tickets. Hi, Eric.
Yeah, the gold tickets are passes for people who live in Crestline to go back home for the first time in 4 or 5 days. These are people who had to evacuate because of the fires. They are the first, the ones who live in Crestline and can provide proof that will be allowed to go home. We're here at Wildwood Park, 40th and Waterman Streets here in San Bernardino, and take a look at the line. Stretches all the way back there, and then you come around this way, and it goes a long way down here as well. This started at 9 o'clock this morning. These people began waiting in line, and they've got to show some kind of proof, maybe a gas bill, a driver's license that has an address in Crestline. They go up there, and they get the gold passes, which allow them to go home, and they were so happy to get those. How you doing? You got the gold pass. Hi. Are you excited?
Yes, I am. I get to go home. Yay!
Where have you been staying?
In the motel room on Guest Inn on Orange Show.
How's that been?
It's been all right.
Yeah,
it's better than the shelter, because that shelter is packed. There's like 300 people staying in one room, and it's crazy there.
All right, well, congratulations to you. You get to go home. Now, what you may be asking, what happens to the other people who live on the mountain, the folks who live, for example, in Lake Arrowhead or Running Springs? Those people will not be allowed to go home today, but a committee of law enforcement people and emergency service providers will decide when it's safe for them to go, and at that point, they will decide to let them apply for passes here as well so that they, too, can return to their neighborhoods. But you got a lot of excited people here, a lot of happy folks. It is not pleasant to live at the home of a friend or relative or in a motel for long periods of time. They're ready to go. How about you?
I'm ready to go home. I was actually home yesterday, but
now really?
I have my pass and I'm
You kind of did that illegally, I guess.
Well, huh? I'm a probation officer.
Oh, okay. So you were allowed to do
right,
that.
But I'm getting this for my wife.
All right. Terrific. Okay. Congratulations. Go on home.
Eric, I'm curious. Have you seen people turned away, though, that didn't have the proper identification? Maybe folks who had to evacuate so quickly they weren't able to grab a gas bill? Or?
Well, yes, there are some people like that. One of the problems is if you live in the mountains, just about everybody has a P.O. box.
Yeah.
P.O. box on an ID isn't going to do it. In most cases, they want an actual street address that says you live in Crestline.
And what are those
folks
having to do?
They're trying to work with people. You know, they ask them some more questions, try and prove if they really do live there. And then if they decide that they do, or they've got enough evidence, they'll let them do it.
They're trying to be reasonable, I'm sure.
They're trying, totally, yeah. But, I mean, this a lot of these people learned about this from watching our broadcast this morning. And hold on, let's talk to a couple more. You got time?
Absolutely.
It's always nice to have good news. How you doing? You ready to go home?
Hi, Eric. Yes, we are.
What's it been like for you?
We've had our own place to stay overnight in Arcadia with relatives, but my wife and I have been volunteering at the Orange Show shelter every day.
And do you think they've kept people out too long?
Crestline, much of it, I don't believe, was in a danger, but because of the style of valley, for safety's sake, and the limited access and egress.
So you don't fault them?
No, I don't. I don't at all. For safety's sake, yeah, they needed. In fact, I think they should have had VOE and Cedar Pines Park mandatory also.
All right, one more lady who's got a dog here. How you doing?
Hi, fine, thank you.
What's your dog's name?
Misty. And she's ready to go home.
She and you have both been staying in a hotel.
Yeah, at the Hilton. They had all the dogs at the Hilton.
So what are you going to do? What's the first thing you're going to do when you go home?
Take a shower. Yes, unpack and have a drink.
Excellent. All right, congratulations to you. Bye-bye. Yeah, a lot of happy folk.
And a lot of happy dogs, apparently, if they get to stay at the Hilton, not so bad. Glad to see those people getting home, and we're glad to see they're processing them fairly quickly there, Eric.
Yeah, they are glad too.
All right. Thanks very much.